to VARINDIA News are: Israel used cyber weapons on its own citizens. Pegasus, which can turn a mobile phone into a pocket spying device, has sparked global controversy following revelations last year that it was used to spy on journalists and dissidents worldwide. Israel's Defense Ministry, which must approve all exports of Israeli-made defense industry products, has also opened an investigation into sales of Pegasus overseas. Some said that NSO's products seem to solve one of the biggest problems facing law enforcement and intelligence agencies in the 21st century, that criminals and terrorists had better technology for encrypting their communications than investigators had to decrypt them. The criminal world had gone dark even as it was increasingly going global. Apple has sued NSO, seeking to bar the spyware firm from using its products and services, and said it would start notifying users targeted by state-sponsored hacking. NSO Group is the world's most notorious maker of spyware, and the FBI had brought a version of Pegasus, NSO's premier spying tool. For nearly a decade, the Israeli firm had been selling its surveillance software on a subscription basis to law enforcement and intelligence agencies around the world, promising that it could do what no one else, not a private company, not even a state intelligence service, could do: consistently and reliably crack the encrypted communications of any iPhone or Android smartphones. There are certain cases where the courts are struggling to deal with claims by security and intelligence services that an urgent warrant is needed to approve the use of surveillance systems to protect state security and prevent terrorism. According to the business daily Calcalist, Pegasus was also used by police on citizens at the forefront of protests against Mr. Netanyahu last year when he was still Prime Minister, as well as other Israelis. Israeli police have firmly denied the report. Public Security Minister Omar Barlev, a Netanyahu critic who took office as part of the new government that ousted him in June, offered a more nuanced defense, sources said. The Netanyahu governments in Israel have been using Pegasus diplomacy to gain support in international forums and promote nationalism with oppressive and dictatorial regimes. According to the MeitY, NSO had introduced Pegasus at the global market in 2011. It had helped Mexican authorities capture Joaquín Guzmán Loera, the drug lord known as EI Chapo. European investigators had quietly used Pegasus to thwart terrorism plots, fight organized crime, and in one case, take down a global child abuse ring, identifying dozens of suspects in more than 40 countries. As per the Privacy Protection Authority, a division of the ministry said, use of Pegasus to monitor Israeli citizens would constitute a serious violation of privacy, announcing its investigation. Let's look into today's headlines in VARINDIA. MeitY to set rules to put onus on cybercrime reporting on companies. Speaking at the launch of IBM's Security Command Center for Asia Pacific, which has been set up in Bengaluru, Rajiv Chandrasekhar, Minister of State for Electronics and Information Technology, said that MeitY will soon come out with regulations which will put onus on organizations to report any cybercrime that may have happened against them, including data leaks. In doing so, Chandrasekhar said the government would ensure that cyberspace remained a safe, trusted and open space for all. HPE unveils private 5G offering. Hewlett Packard Enterprises has announced the company is getting into private 5G space. As part of the venture, HPE said they were bringing together cellular and Wi-Fi for private networking in enterprise, industrial and public sector use cases. HPE's private 5G offering is claiming to be easily usable in both 5G and Wi-Fi networks across campuses and industrial environments. The private 5G solution is based on the HPE 5G core stack, an open, cloud-native and container-based network solution. The private 5G solution has also been pre-integrated with 5G radio access network solutions from leading vendors for providing customers with end-to-end 5G network deployments. Cohere Technologies raises $46 million in Series D round. Cohere Technologies has raised $46 million in Series D investment led by Koch Investments Group to finalize the commercialization of its Universal Spectrum Multiplier Open Radio Access Network software for 4G, 5G and emerging 6G mobile networks. Cohere also revealed that it had evolved its spectrum software functionalities to deliver up to 2x spectrum performance boost for both 4G and 5G networks simultaneously when spectrum is being shared using its USM service. IBM to launch Cybersecurity Hub in Bengaluru. International Business Machines Corporations is launching a cybersecurity hub in Bengaluru to address the concerns of its clients across the Asia-Pacific region. The security hub will be one of the only two centers globally. The other one is in the US. IBM said it is a multi-million dollar investment in its resources to help businesses prepare for and manage the growing threat of cybersecurity to organizations across the APAC region. 9 WordPress plugins discover vulnerabilities in over 1.3 million sites. The United States government vulnerability database and WordPress security researchers published alerts of WordPress plugin vulnerabilities. Among those plugins, 9 of the most popular plugins affect over 1.3 million websites. According to the National Vulnerability Database, the pop-up builder WordPress plugin before 4.0.7 does not validate and properly escape the overwrite and order parameters before using them in a SQL statement in the admin dashboard, which could allow high-privileged users to perform SQL injections. That's all for now. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to VARINDIA News Magazine. You can download the VARINDIA app from Google Play Store and Apple App Store for the latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.